New York City has a big Ukrainian neighborhood. Yeah, big, very big. Only because New York's big, but there's a, it's a very big, on 3rd Avenue, there's a church, very big Ukrainian church. But if you ever go to Chicago, my neighbor is where all the Ukrainians are.
Oh.
By drive, yes. By plane, it's like an hour and a half. Hour and a half.
By car, it's distance.
It's about 11 hours. 8 hours if you push it, but really 11 hours if legal. Yeah. We go by gallons, you go by liter here. So a gallon in the US is roughly about $2.80, about $3.
Yeah, for example, if your car takes 10 liters, how
many
gallons
do you need? I don't know. Is that that's a full tank?
No, for example, average. For example, a 3 liter diesel, how many is this?
Well, if I fill up my car, full tank, it's gonna cost me about $35. Yeah.
And how many gallons do you have?
About 16 to 18.
16
gallons.
16 gallons.
Yeah, I don't know what the conversion is.
Uh-huh. And what car do you have?
I drive a Honda, an SUV, so it's very fuel efficient. Yeah, it's like an SUV, a small SUV.
It's near, I think, 50 liters will be.
50?
Yes, 50 liters, something like that.
50.
Yes,
okay.
50.
Okay. So.
So and you pay for this? Full tank?
Yeah, it's about $35.
$35.
Why is that expensive?
No, it's too cheap.
Yeah.
For example, here.
Okay. That's about 70 US.
Yeah, 70 US.
Wow.
Yes.
That's expensive. I thought petrol has gotten cheap here too. It's not cheap here? Gas is not cheap here?
Twice lower price.
It's much lower than before. Wow. Have you been back to Ukraine or no?
No.
No,
because
it's too dangerous? They might put you in the army.
No, but there is no Putin army, it's just like, there is guys who paid them, like contract, just contract army, yes. But not like regular army or Russians. Well,
there's no regular army in Ukraine?
No.
Oh. It's not mandatory army.
It's just guys who go for war just for money.
Just for mercenaries.
Yes. Who was, for example, in Chechnya, some Afghanistan, in such places, who know how to.
So this is not a battle that the Ukrainians really want to fight.
Yes.
Wants to fight this war? Just the Eastern Ukrainians?
but the other new politics, they don't know what to do. Because they take money, for example,
Well, but people are dying. Sorry. Okay. So I'm following you. Which way? But unfortunately, there's a lot of people dying. Okay. Because most likely the way this ends is they're gonna split up Ukraine. Ukraine will be two countries. It'll be an eastern Ukraine owned by the Russians. So the only one who cares about this war is politicians. Okay. Do you have friends involved? Like family and friends or no? You have a few friends, okay. Ooh. Okay, I'm not in the middle now, okay. Oh wow.
It will be really nice. I live in this part of Prague, 3 minutes walking from this place, and every day I was here.
Wow, this is beautiful. What's this called?
It's Letna Park. It's the biggest park in Prague.
Letna Park. Could you take a picture of me so I don't think anyone believes I'm doing this? Thank you. So, but what happens at the end when the Russians want more than just if they actually push forward? Will that at that time will you want to get involved?
No.
Not at all, huh?
No, nobody don't want a war.
But how about if they do? If they decide, hey, you know what?
To go
further. It's tough, right?